Dear learners, we have been discussing William Empson's 7 types of ambiguity. As the part of the discussion in the earlier session, we discussed William Empson as a critic. And in this session, I am going to explain you the meaning and definition of ambiguity based on William Empson's view, which is prescribed for BA 5th semester optional English. This is session 46. The learning objective of this particular session is to enable the students to understand the views of William Empson on ambiguity. And the session outcomes will be, you will be able to understand the meaning and definitions of ambiguity after the discussion. Then, what is the meaning of ambiguity? Ambiguity is having more than one indeterminate meaning. Dvandva anta kannadadalli helabahudu. Ambiguity is having more than one indeterminate meaning. Ondakkinta hechu anirdishta arthagalanna hondiruvudanna ambiguity anta William Empson ಆಧಾರವಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯ ಅರ್ಥದಲ್ಲೂ ಸಹಿತ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಜನರಲ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಂಬಿಗ್ವಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಂಬಿಗ್ಯುಯಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಂಬಿಗ್ಯುಯಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡಿನರಿ ಯೂಸೇಜ್ ಆಂಬಿಗ್ವಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ಅ ಫಾಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಯಲಿ in the general communication, in the general conversation, ambiguity is a fault in style. It's an error. That is, usage of your vague or equivocal term of expression when what is wanted is precision and particularity of reference. In the general conversation, we want precision and particularity of references. But sometimes, if you do not have that particularity or the precision in your conversation, we call it ambiguity, and in this sense, ambiguity is the negativity in the style. But in literature, it is different. According to William Empson, in literature, in poetry, ambiguity is the, it's a characteristic of good poetry. If the poem has more than one meaning, it's a good poem. If it is having only one meaning, one superficial meaning, it's a common poem according to William Empson. So, having then more than one meaning or having ambiguity in poetry is the good characteristics according to William Empson. Look at the picture there. Only. It suggests only, but which way is to go? There is no clarity about that. And ambiguity is like that. Ambiguity is having more than one meaning, indeterminate meanings. Then multiple meaning and plurisignation are alternative terms for this use of language. Ambiguity means plurisignation. Signation means sign, suchane anta. Plura, bahutva. Vidavidavada, bahutvada, bere bere suchanegalanna koduvantiddare. Alternative terms is called ambiguity. Multiple meaning and plurisignation are alternative terms for this use of language. You can call ambiguity is a multiple meaning. Ambiguity means plurisignation. They have the advantage of avoiding the pejorative association with the word ambiguity. Then, Empson, impressed by the multiplicity of meanings revealed in an analysis by Robert Graves and Laura Riding of Shakespeare's sonnet, The Expense of Spirit in a Waste of Shame, set out to explore the applicability of this kind of analysis to English poetry in general. Read here. Empson was influenced by Robert Graves and Laura Riding. This Robert Graves and Laura Riding, they explained Shakespeare's sonnet. They criticized Shakespeare's sonnet. The title of the sonnet is The Expense of the Spirit in a Waste of Shame. And in their explanation, they showed that how different meanings are going to enrich the effect of poetry. And Empson was influenced by that, and he applied this kind of interpretation to the whole English poetry in general. The result was the publication of 7 Types of Ambiguity in the year 1930. So, he was influenced by these two critics, and The result of that influence was the Seven Types of Ambiguity, which he published in the year 1930. Then, in Seven Types of Ambiguity, Empson sought out to enhance the reader's understanding of a poem by isolating the linguistic properties of the text. He isolates the linguistic properties of the text. He sought to enhance the reader's understanding. He helps readers to understand poetry by isolating the linguistic properties of the text. He suggests that the words or references in poems are ambiguous and, if presented coherently, carry multiple meanings that can enrich the reader's appreciation of the works. So poetry has words, you know that, and those words have different meanings, and that different meanings are going to enrich the meaning and the effect of the poetry in the reader. So when you are reading poetry, you need to give importance to the different meanings in the word, different meanings of the word that exist in the poetry. If you are not understanding, if you are not, you know, paying interest, if you are not stressing on the different meanings of the poetry, you are going to miss the meaning of the actual poetry. Then he argued that the complexities of cognitive and tonal meanings in poetry form the basis of reader's emotional response. He says that the complexities of cognitive and tonal meanings, cognitive means understanding, and the tone, different the meanings, tonal meanings in poetry, form the basis of the reader's emotional response. These different meanings are going to, you know, the enrich the experience of reading poetry in the reader. He presents the different kinds of ambiguity or types of logical disorder in the order of increasing distance from simple statement and logical exposition. What he does, he presents the different kinds of ambiguity. He is going to classify the types of ambiguity, types of logical disorder, in the order of increasing distance from simple statement and logical exposition. So, simple statement, if you read a poem for a first time, you will get some, you know, a simple kind of meaning. And if you go on reading the poetry, giving importance to the different meanings of the poem, you are going to understand poem in a different manner. It's going to appear to you in a different manner. Empson uses the word ambiguity in a social sense as any consequence of language, however slight, which adds some nonsense to the direct statement of prose. According to Empson, ambiguity means a consequence of language. It may be slight and it adds some nonsense, variations, to the direct statement of a prose. So direct statement of prose, that's different, and ambiguity is having more than one possible meanings. Words may possess several distinct meanings. There may be different meanings in the poems. So Empson is interested in catching overtones of expressions. He was interested in finding different expressions, different overtones of expression, hidden nuances and implications not revealed by superficial reading of the text. If you read the text in superficial manner, you will find some meaning. But Empson was interested in the meaning that are not superficial, that are not possible to get in one reading. Subtleties and indirections precipitated by means of protracted analysis and developed technique of free association. So different meaning that exists in the poetry are important for Empson than superficial meaning. And you can find those different meanings by understanding the ambiguities in the work of art. Empson's classification of ambiguity, classification of ambiguities into seven types, is not, as he himself makes clear, to be pressed too hard. That classification is not scientific, we can say. Scientific study it is actually, but it's not much, it should not be given much importance to that classification. In words, there is probability, in short, that one or the other or both of two things has been meant. In poetry, when you are reading poetry, there is a possibility that one meaning is correct, or the poet wanted to express this one meaning. Sometime you can find two different meanings. Sometime one is correct, another may not be correct. Sometime both are correct. So meaning is arbitrary there. Ambiguity is not a specific figurative device. It's not a figurative device which may be chosen at will for decoration. It may not be chosen by the poet for a decorative reason. It's not a device actually. It's not, says Emerson, a thing to be attempted. It should not be attempted by the poet. Rather, it's a natural characteristic of language which becomes heightened and significant in verse. Poet should not try for this, but it's the feature of a good poetry. It is a natural characteristic of language that becomes heightened and significant in verse especially than in prose. Emerson's aim in his close analysis is not to identify the one right meaning. Emerson is not interested in finding one correct meaning, but to explore the expanding possibilities of alternate, multiple and simultaneous meanings. He is interested in finding different meanings rather than one meaning. Different, alternate, multiple and simultaneous meanings that exist in poetry. For that, Emerson gives importance than finding one meaning there. So this was all about Emerson's the meaning and definitions of ambiguity according to Emerson's views. Let us discuss those seven types in particular in our next session. Thank you for listening.